الحمد لله، الحمد لله، الحمد لله، نستعينه ونستغفره ونستهديه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا، من يهد الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ولا مثيل له في علو شأنه وعظيم سلطانه، ونشهد أن سيدنا ومولانا محمدًا عبده وحبيبه ورسوله أرسله من أرجح العرب ميزانًا وأفصحها بيانًا فأوضح الطريقة ونصح الخليقة صلى الله تعالى عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه وأزواجه وأولاده وذريته وخلفائه المهديين من بعده ووزرائه العاملين في عهده، خصوصا منهم على الأئمة خلفاء رسول الله على التحقيق أمراء المؤمنين حضرات أبي بكر وعمر وعثمان وعلي ذوي القدر الجليل، وعلى بقية الصحابة والتابعين رضوان الله تعالى عليهم أجمعين. أيها المؤمنون الحاضرون، اتقوا الله وأطيعوه، إن الله مع الذين اتقوا والذين هم محسنون. All Muslims, believers, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves from His servant to be humble. Humbleness is the symbol of love. If you are humble, Allah and His Prophet loves you. If we are not humble, we are arrogant, then Allah and His Prophet will not love us. We have to be very careful when we are climbing this member or any member of a masjid, because it is member of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. It is not your own member that you like to speak what you like. It is the member of Islam. It is the symbol of Islam. And that's why it is very to pay attention very well that this place is the place where we can show humbleness. If we think we are scholars or we are khatib, we are wrong. Allah said in Holy Quran, وَفَوْقَ كُلِّ ذِي عِلْمٍ عَلِيمٍ. Above every knower there is knower. Even if you memorize the whole Quran, even you have studied the Sharia, even you study the Hadith of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, this must take you to be humble, or else we have to be very worried. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said to Sahaba, "Ala akhbirukum bi ahli al-jannah?" Of course, when Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Do you like me to tell you who are the people of paradise?" Everyone likes to know who are the people of paradise, because we are asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala not to punish us but to send us to paradise to be with Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, the people of paradise, كل ضعيف متضعف لو أقسم على الله لأبره. Everyone that he humble himself, throw away arrogance from his heart, show humbleness to everyone. There was a very big scholar in Islam, Abu Yazid al-Bastami. He said in his famous quote, "I respect those who are younger than me, and I respect those who are older than me. My duty is to respect Not my duty is to be respected. I don't care if people respect me or not, but I care that myself to respect the young and the old. And they said, Ya Abu Yazid, how is that? He said, when I look at the one who is younger than me, I see and I know that he did less sin than me. He didn't do too much sins because he's younger than me, I am older than him. So I have to respect him because he is less sinner. We are not saying that people will not make sin. No, all of us will make sin, but we have to repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala every time we know that we committed a sin. And to the old ones older than me, I respected them because I feel that they made worshipness more than me. So both sides, I have to respect. Because this is what Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Ahlul Jannah, the people of paradise, are kullu da'if. Da'if here in the meaning not the weak, he has no health, no. Da'if means the one that he always make himself simple. Simple person. You might come to a masjid, you can see someone who is very simple sitting there after he works, after his duty with his family and his house, coming to the masjid, sitting and praying. That is a simple person. And then Prophet ﷺ said, أَلَا أُخْبِرُكُمْ بِأَهْلِ النَّارِ. Do you want me to tell you who are the people of hellfire? May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us. كل عطل جواز مستكبر. Every كل عطل, عطل means كل جاهل. Everyone ignorant makes himself as if he is the best. And مستكبر, arrogant. No one can speak with him. Do you find in your life when you are meeting people, you might be like that from within yourself. I might be like that. You might be like that. That's why arrogance, Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam made Sahaba to throw it from their hearts. Arrogance will not last. Arrogance will kill you. Who killed Iblis? Who made Iblis to be cursed? Allah? No. Allah cursed him, yes. But who made him to be cursed? His arrogance. His arrogance to make sajda by order of Allah to Iblis, to astaghfirullah, to Adam alayhi salam. Iblis refused because he thought himself is the best. So that's character of thinking the self is the best is what his arrogance comes from. Like professors in the universities, you might find a class, a professor who's very humble. He accepts everyone. Everyone can speak with him, can ask him. He's very patient. And you might find another professor, he doesn't like to speak with his student. I'm a professor, your student, listen to me. That's arrogance. All Muslims, let us throw away arrogance from our hearts. If we want to be, to succeed, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will bless us. Look at this hadith of Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, narrated by Bukhari and Muslim. And it is very important. He said عن أبي العباس سهل بن سعد الساعدي رضي الله عنه أنه قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said مر رجل على النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. One day a man, I was sitting with Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم and a man passed in front of us. فقال لرجل عنده Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said to someone sitting with us ما رأيك في هذا؟ What is your opinion about this man? Look, Prophet, how much he wants to teach us. He doesn't. He wants to get you a proof and to tell you a story in his hadith in order that we learn it. That man passing, one passing, and Sahaba city, and he said to one of them, "What's your opinion about that man who is passing?" فقال رجل من أشراف الناس, a man from the elite of community, from the highest level of community. That's when you look at him, you like to run to him, to speak with him, to be friend with him. والله حري إن خطب أن ينكح. انخطب أن ينكح or ينكح means if he will ask to marry, people will run quickly and they accept to give him their daughter because he is a man of respect by people. وإن شفع أن يشفع, and if someone come to him to intervene for him for a sub problem within the community, the people will listen to him. He can intervene. Like you go to an important person and say, please, I have this problem, can you speak with the officers higher than you? He can. So this is a type of man. فسكت رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. Prophet didn't say anything. He let it to go. And still they were sitting. And ومر رجل آخر. And another man came through. فقال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم to the first one who asked him about what's your opinion of this person. He asked him another time, what is the opinion of this second person that is passing here? فقال يا رسول الله, يا رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم, هذا رجل من فقراء المسلمين. This man is from the poor society of Muslims. He's very poor. حري إن خطب أن لا ينكح. If he will go to ask to marry, people will refuse him. Disgusted person. Has no value. They look at him bad. Who is coming to ask the hand of my daughter? We have this problem. This is our problem today. We must be very careful. And to read that hadith of Prophet ﷺ and understand it. وَإِن شَفَعَ أَن لَا يُشَفَعَ. And if he intervenes for someone, no one will listen to him. You cannot ask him to intervene for anyone. وَإِن قَالَ لَا يُسْمَعُ لِقَوْلِهِ. And if he said something, no one will listen to him. Because people are arrogant. That is the kibar, that is the arrogance. Al-kibriya. Al-kibriya is only for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Not everyone can be arrogant. Allah, one of his name, Al-Mutakabbir, the one who has the kibriya, has the power, has the full to be arrogant on anything. No one else. Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam never showed arrogance in his life. He was with his children as if he was dealing with men, and with the men the same way of dealing, respecting everyone. What do you think the answer of Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Goes for the first man or the second man? For the man that is from the elite of the community, or for the man from the poor of the community? And what Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said. وَقَالَ فَقَالَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ. And he said, هَذَا خَيْرٌ مِنْ مِلْءِ الْأَرْضِ مِثْلِ هَذَا. This one The second one, the poor one, is better from the first one. Even there are millions and millions and the earth is full from the first one, that poor one is better than the first one. Even the whole earth is full of that. That one is more valuable, the poor one, to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Why? Because he is a humble person. He is not arrogant. He has nothing to be arrogant with. People look at him bad, but Allah look at him good. So the evaluation of human beings are not by their wealth. The evaluation of a human being are not their position, by their position. The evaluation of a human being are not by their post. The evaluation of a human being is how much purity there is in their hearts. That is what is important. All Muslims, this is a Friday, and dua is accepted. Let us ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us humbleness in our hearts and to take away arrogance from our hearts. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله العظيم لي ولكم ولسائر المستغفرين فيا فوز للمستغفرين أستغفر الله.
اللهم صل وسلم وسلم وعافيك وعافيك
والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا ونبينا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد صاحب الحسن والجمال وحبيب الرحمن. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. الصلاة والسلام عليك يا سيدي يا رسول الله، الصلاة والسلام عليك يا سيدي يا حبيب الله، الصلاة والسلام عليك يا من أرسلك الله تعالى رحمة للعالمين. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد كما صليت على سيدنا إبراهيم وعلى آل سيدنا إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد. وبارك اللهم على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد كما باركت على سيدنا إبراهيم وعلى آل سيدنا إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد. اللهم اغفر للمؤمنين والمؤمنات والمسلمين والمسلمات الأحياء منهم والأموات، واغفر لنا ولإخواننا الذين سبقونا بالإيمان، ولا تجعل في قلوبنا غلا للذين آمنوا، ربنا إنك رؤوف رحيم يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم انصر الإسلام والمسلمين وأعز كلمة هذا الدين، إنك على كل شيء قدير وبالإجابة جدير. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار، وأدخلنا الجنة مع الأبرار برحمتك يا عزيز يا غفار يا كريم يا ستار يا رب العالمين. اللهم أجرنا من عذاب القبر ومن عذاب النار ومن فتنة المحيا والممات ومن فتنة المسيح الدجال. اللهم ارزقنا شفاعة حبيبك المصطفى عليه أفضل الصلاة والسلام. اللهم شرفنا برؤيته، اللهم احشرنا معه في مقعد صدق عند مليك مقتدر. وصلى الله على سيدنا ونبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون، وسلام على المرسلين، والحمد لله رب العالمين. إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون ولذكر الله أكبر والله يعلم ما تصنعون. أقم الصلاة.
الله أكبر.